Well, good evening, folks. It's another worship session, pure worship as we do it here. And we encourage you to call someone and share this link, give a thumbs up, make a comment, or even subscribe so that when we go live, you would be notified. So we thank you for taking the time to join us as we seek to give God all his deserved worship.
Amen.
Pure
Amen.
Worship. Yes. Join us as we worship the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. God is good. Thank you.
give thanks with a grateful heart for all that the Lord has done for us. We give thanks because we have recognized that we ought to be grateful for what the Lord has done and for who He is. And when we talk about giving thanks, we often think about material things that we should give thanks for. And that's all right. It's good to give thanks for our material blessings, by all means. However, we must see beyond the material blessings. God is the giver of every good and perfect gift. We owe Him our lives. Every breath we take is a gift. Every pleasure we enjoy is a gift. Every satisfaction we derive is a gift. The majesty and beauty of creation is a gift of love from the Lord of creation. Let's look at the three first verses in Psalms 136 to remind ourselves of some of the reasons we should thank the Lord for. In Psalms 136 verse 1 and 3, it says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of gods. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. His love endures forever." The first thing David says we should give thanks unto the Lord for is because of His goodness. For He is good. Amen. The word good is used so often that unless we stop and think about what the word means, it's easy for us to miss the point of why we should give thanks. So let's think about what this phrase, God is good. What that phrase really means. God is good and not evil. Amen. We all know that there are good things and there are bad things in this world. God is good in the sense that God's character is pure, is holy, and yes, good. God is not stained by evil. His motives are not corrupt. He is not double-minded or two-faced. He does not compromise His character, and He never gives in to that which is evil. Amen. In God's goodness, He will judge the wicked. That is, all those who are not hidden, if they are not hidden themselves in the sacrifice of Christ. God is constantly good. The Bible says there is no shadow of turning in Him. There is not a hint that God will compromise His evil or go back on His promise or abandon those who He loves. Because God is good all the time. Amen. And all the time, amen. God is good. God is good in the sense that He is competent. When you have a good employee, you mean that this is a person who works well. They do their job with excellence. They grasp ideas. They are a good team player. They get it. When we talk about God being good, we mean that He is competent. He is God who rules with wisdom and excellent. And I'm grateful that God has a plan in the confusing time that we are living in. I am comforted to know that God knows what He is doing. He has a purpose for the things He allowed to come into our lives, and it's always for our good. And sometimes He's teaching us, sometimes He's disciplining us. Sometimes He is building character or teaching us things that we will need to know for the future. And sometimes He's preparing us for something better. And other times He's preparing something better for us. Amen. Sometimes He is working in our midst to give us opportunity for ministry, testimony, and witness. The point is, God has a plan. He exercises His role as the ruler of the universe with wisdom and power and majesty and skill. Amen. So yes, we give thanks to the Lord because He is good. Secondly, David said we should give thanks unto the Lord because of the godness of God. Look at the way David begins each of these three verses. Give thanks to the Lord, give thanks to the God of God, and give thanks to the Lord of lords. Amen. In 1 Corinthians 2 and 8, it says that Jesus is the Lord of glory. the only person who paid for our sins with his life and rose again from the dead for our justification triumphantly. It is Jesus. Amen. So the psalmist is not suggesting that we give thanks to some undefiled spiritual being that makes us feel safe and secure. He is not advocating that we thank our spirit guide or a spiritual presence or some to be grateful to some God concept. God, David urges us to give thanks to the one true and supreme God. The Apostle Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians 8:4-6, we know that an idol is nothing at all in this world, and there is no God but one. For even if there are so-called gods, whether in heaven or on earth, as indeed there are many gods and many lords, yet for us there is but one God, the Father, from whom all things came and for whom we live. And there is but one Lord, Jesus Christ, through whom all things came and through whom we live. Amen. Amen. In the same way, there are lots of religious voices in the world today, but for us there is but one Lord, Jesus, the Lord of glory. For in him dwelt all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. Amen. So we give thanks to the Lord because he is good and because he is God. The third reason David gives for us to be grateful to the Lord for, to give thanks for, is the focal point of the Psalms, because of the greatness of God's love for us. His love endures forever, he says. Now this phrase repeats itself 26 times in this psalm. In the King James, the phrase reads, his mercy endures forever. Both phrases are saying the same thing. And let's try to understand this phrase, his love or his mercy endures forever. First, God loves us so much, and it's not freckled like much of the love of the world. In sports, we talk about fair weather fans. There are those who would cheer for the team when they are doing well, but abandon them when they struggle. And much of the love of the world is like this. People would be nice to you when they want something from you. They express love when things are pleasant between them. But the moment things turn, the circumstance change, their feelings towards us change. Amen. They were our friends as long as we agree with them. And those who were friends yesterday turn away today. And this happens so often and in so many ways that today we tend to project this kind of love on God. And this is a grave mistake, friend, because God's love is constant. Amen. Amen. His love endure forever, day in and day out. Every day you get out of your bed in the morning, you can be sure of one thing. God loves you. Amen. Second, God's love is certain in difficult times. I don't mean to say or imply that God loves everything we do. Like a good parent, God doesn't agree with all our choices. He doesn't like some of the thoughts that crosses our mind, and he hates some of the things we do. However, like a good parent, he will be there for us when we need him with unfailing love. It is often said that you don't know who your true friends are until you go through a time of difficulty, a sickness, or a divorce, a conviction, an unplanned pregnancy, a financial disaster. Unfortunately, we find that in these times, some of the people we thought were our friends are quick to turn their back on us. And your true friends are the ones who will step forward in difficult times rather than step back. Because of God's great love towards us, he can be counted on. He will be there to pick us up when we fall. Yeah. He will be there to rejoice with us when we succeed. He is committed to us. And even though we are freckled and our faith runs hot and cold, even though the world changes, God's love is consistent and it's constant. Amen. Because Amen. It endures forever. Amen. Thirdly, God's love gives us true security, which leads to abiding joy. It is a wonderful thing to experience an unconditional kind of love. It is what all long for, but few find. We want to know that there is someone whom we can always call on, and regardless of the circumstances, they will be there for us. Can you think of such a person in your life? Well, if you can't, know this. There is someone who has never and will never fail in his everlasting love towards you. Amen. Mm-hmm. Jesus, amen. The Lord of glory. When you feel secure in your relationship with God, you will stop looking over your shoulder, waiting for the bad things in your life to catch up with you. You will no longer have to be afraid of a failure, because you know, come what may, His love endures forever. When you understand the security of God's love, you don't have to be afraid of condemnation, for there is no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. His love is sure, and you can stop beating yourself up over the past, for God has removed your sins as far as the east is from the west. He remembers them no more. What joy it is to know that what God means it when He says, if you confess your sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And when God forgives, the issue is closed. Amen. The past is no longer a factor. Amen. Hallelujah. It has been dealt with. So we can move on. We can let go. Amen.
Amen.
After all, that's why Jesus died on Calvary's cross, that you and I might have forgiveness of sin. What a love that why we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And as we learn to rest in His love, we find our life is no longer characterized by extreme high and followed by extreme low. Instead, there is a constancy of joy that is anchored in the security of God's love. The Bible calls it a joy unspeakable and full of glory. The security that says God is working all things out for my good. And His plans for us is to prosper us and not to harm us. Plan to give us hope and a future. Glory to God.
Amen.
Let's try to draw some practical applications here.
Hallelujah.
So we say, first, God is good. Since God is good, and we say that God is great. Mm-hmm. So since God is great, the way we conduct ourselves should always be one that express gratitude. We should always be grateful to Him every moment of our lives. Amen. With our words, with our thoughts, with our action, everything we do and say. We might not always get it right, but we can give Him thanks always. Amen.
Amen.
If there is one thing you can
do,
is thank the Lord at all times. Amen. The writer to the Hebrews says in chapter 13 and verse 15, by Him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually. That is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to His name. And Paul wrote in Colossians chapter 3 and verse 17, and whatsoever we do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father by Him. He wrote in Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 20, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And many other verses exhorts us to give thanks. And this is in agreement with what the psalmist is saying here in Psalm 136. Give thanks to the Lord because He is good. Give thanks to the Lord because He is God. Give thanks to the Lord because of His great love towards us. Amen. And I want to encourage you today. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks.
Give thanks
with a grateful heart. Give Him thanks.
Give thanks unto the Lord. Give thanks.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
thanks. Hallelujah.
Give
God thanks. Give you thanks, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be the name of Jesus. I'm sure you could think of so many things that you could give thanks for.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. We want to continue giving God thanks as we express gratitude and be grateful for what the Lord has done in our lives.
Amen.
The Lord is good. Somebody say, He has done me well.
Amen.
Oh, my soul, hallelujah. Rise up and praise the Lord. Amen. And this song is called Grateful. And I want to encourage you to sing it with us as we express our gratitude. It said, this is the day that you have made. Whatever comes, I won't complain. For all my hope is in your name. And now your joy awaits my praise. Amen. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. With a grateful heart, give thanks unto the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
May God bless you. Continue to have yourself a wonderful week. Until next Sunday, God blessings
God bless
be upon you.